Our topic today for our material balance lecture series is about steady state and unsteady state. So, simulan natin i-discuss kung ano ba yung tinatawag nating steady state system. So, again, let us assume that this tank is our system, no? And the walls of the tank will serve as our system boundary. And then, this is an open system wherein 100 kilograms of water is entering our tank per minute. And also, there are 100 kilograms of water exiting the tank per minute. So, as you can see guys, dito sa ating system, meron pumapasok na 100 kilogram ng water and then may lumalabas din ng 100 kilogram ng water, no? So, same yung amount ng entering and exiting material natin dito. The conditions inside the process, specifically the amount of water in the example vessel above, remains unchanged in time. So, in a steady state system, yung condition ng ating material sa loob ng ating system will remain unchanged. And also, the condition of the flowing streams remain constant with time. So, ganun din yung pumapasok at lumalabas na material sa ating system, constant din yung kanyang condition through time. Therefore, in a steady state process, all the conditions in the process, for example, temperature, pressure, mass of material, flow rate, etc., remains constant with time. And we can say that this is a continuous process if the material enters and or leaves the system without any interruption. So, dun lang natin masasabi na continuous system siya kapag yung material natin pumapasok or lumalabas sa ating system na walang kahit anumang interruption na nangyayari. Now, ano naman yung tinatawag nating unsteady state system? So again, consider ulit natin itong tank natin as our system, no? And the walls of the tank is our system boundary. And then meron tayong initial condition dito ng ating system. Sa loob ng tank natin, meron tayong 1000 kilogram of water. And then let's say meron pumapasok na water, katulad kanina, 100 kilogram of water is entering per minute. However, ang pinakaiba nito is that the exiting water is 90 kilogram per minute. So therefore, may nangyayaring accumulation dito. Dahil ang pumapasok nating water is 100 kilogram at ang lumalabas ay 90 lang. So sa makatawid, merong nangyayaring accumulation na 10 kilograms per minute. Therefore, yung amount ng water present in the vessel will depend on the interval of time for which the rate of accumulation is maintained. So, yung amount ng water na nasa loob ng system natin is magdidepende sa rate, no, na pumapasok at lumalabas. So, dahil magkaiba yung rate ng pumapasok at lumalabas na material sa ating system, nakakaroon ng pagbabago sa kondisyon ng material natin na nasa loob ng system. Now, let us see what will happen after 50 minutes. So, this is now our system, no? Nagkaroon ng accumulation na 500 kilogram. Dahil ang pumapasok is 100 kilogram per minute and then lumalabas na 90 kilogram per minute. So, ang water na nag-accumulate sa ating system is 10 kilograms per minute times 50 minutes which is equal to 500 kilogram ng water. And because the amount of water in the system changes with time, the process and system are deemed to be an unsteady state or transient process or system. Therefore, in an unsteady state process, not all the conditions in process like temperature, pressure, mass, or material remains constant with time. And the flow in and flow out on the system can vary with time. So, I hope naging malinaw yung pinagkaiba ng steady state and unsteady state system sa atin. Now, let us have another example. Again, this is our system boundary. Bago tayo magpatuloy sa ating discussion, we would like to ask for your support to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Please click on the notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga ipopost naming mga video. We also like to invite you to register sa aming website, www.enginerds.org. Our website is an online community for Filipino engineers, engineering students, and STEM students. Now, meron ulit tayong initial condition na 1,000 kg water inside ng ating tank. Ngayon, ang pumapasok ngayon is 90 kilogram lang per minute. And then, ang lumalabas is 100 kilogram per minute. So, dahil magkaiba uli yung ating flow rate ng in and out, therefore, magkakaroon uli ng changes sa material na nasa loob ng ating system, no? Yung water accumulation will be 90 minus 100 kilogram. Therefore, meron tayo ditong negative accumulation, no? Na 10 kilograms per minute. Therefore, the amount of water in the system decreases with time at the rate of 10 kilograms per minute. So, let us see what will happen after 50 minutes. As you can see, the material in our system decreases because it is decreasing by the rate of 10 kilograms per minute. So, we have negative accumulation dito ng water. No? Negative 10 kilograms per minute times 50 minutes is equal to minus 500 kilogram in 50 minutes. Therefore, from the examples na nakita natin, we will have this equation. No? Yung accumulation of material within the system is equal to total flow into the system minus total flow out of the system. So, ito yung formula na basically magagamit natin to calculate kung gaano karami yung magiging accumulation natin sa ating system. Now, let us take a review on what we have learned so far. Accumulation of material within the system is equal to total flow into the system minus total flow out of the system. If the process is in the steady state, the accumulation term by definition is zero. So, walang accumulation na nangyayari if we are in steady state system. While if the process is in unsteady state system, the accumulation term over time interval is calculated as per what you can see below. Water accumulation is equal to 100 kilogram minus 90, no? So, water accumulation is equal to in minus out. Therefore, in our example, our accumulation is equal to 10 kilogram per minute. So, therefore, our formula for accumulation is equal to final material in the system minus initial material in the system. The above are the general material balance for component in the system in the absence of reaction. So, ito yung gagamitin natin kapag walang reaction na nangyayari sa ating system. To answer material balance problems, you will have to select the times for the final and initial condition. And we will be discussing that in our succeeding videos on how to choose a basis whenever we are doing material balance problems. So, in general, ito ang ating magiging overall formula in calculating for accumulation. Accumulation is equal to in minus out plus generated minus consumed. Well, that's all for now, guys. Thank you for watching and please subscribe sa aming YouTube channel. Click on the notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa mga videos na ipopost namin. Please register also sa aming website na www.enginerds.org. It is an online community for Filipino engineers, engineering students, and STEM students. So that's all for now, guys. Thank you very much and have a nice day.